West Yorkshire, Love Lane.
Why do birds suddenly appear every time you are near? Just like me, they long to be close to you.
At bottom of everybody, they want to find love and be loved. It must be awful not to be loved.
Why do stars fall down from the sky every time you walk by?
I feel that I had to go through that hurt and that stress and unhappiness, really, to appreciate the good things in life.
Just like me, they long to be close to you.
How can somebody just put a word onto a feeling that you've got? Could be called anything, couldn't it? It doesn't have to be called love. It's just a word. It's just something one person says to another.
Just like me, they long to be close to you.
Love Lane, they do love one another. People are great up here.
Whenever I see anybody off Love Lane, I don't see them as a stranger. It's family. It's family to me.
I went out with this guy, and I knew he'd got this hobby. Anyway, it turned out that he was in the operatic society, which I got a bit of stick about. And once I found out, then he kept buying, fetching all these tickets home, so I had to go to his performances. And he was absolutely crap. All my relationships have really been sort of long-term ones, I suppose. And just the odd dates in between. I've clung on to relationships before that have not been good for me. Some relationships have been quite shallow. I shouldn't have really bothered with. But you do these things when you're young and foolish.
It's just Judy's.
Yeah.
I think she's more or less bamboozled him into doing it.
I lived with a guy. I suppose that was the first serious relationship, and yeah, that broke my heart when that ended. We just grew apart. We wanted different things out of it. I wanted to settle down. I got into that mode where I wanted to settle down, and he wanted to go off on an adventure, and I didn't, so it ended.
I'd hate not to be loved. I'd be a lonely old woman. Well, I was told nothing about life. Just behave yourself. Don't go it, lads, and that were it. As a child, I always thought I'd find love in Love Lane. But I didn't. I found it at Featherston Welfare. The first time I saw him, he was at my grandma's. I was 14. Oh, and I thought he were awful. Nice looking, but I just didn't like him. But yet, when I was 17, I went to a dance at Featherston Welfare with my pal, and as soon as I saw him, ooh, something clicked. And I mean, I've always been a big eater. And I couldn't eat. My mum thought there was something wrong with me. I couldn't sleep. I felt ill. All them silly things when you look back. But to me then it were lovely. We were in love.
We went for a drink together and things just snowballed from there. It was just a question of, if you like, love at first sight. We got on well, we had so many things in common, we had the same goals, we liked the same things, we enjoyed each other's company, and I can't really say much more than that. It just happened.
I've, like, never ever seen any couple more in love than my mum and dad. Honestly, they're so in love, and, like, it's like their anniversary on Friday, 18 years, and I've never actually met anybody who's been together for more than 18 years and never, like, split up or had a major argument or seen anybody else, and they're just still together. I think it's ace.
It's a feeling that is more than any other feeling, an emotion more than any other emotion.
I were on my own and things weren't going too well, and Jim were on his own and things weren't going too well for him either. And I just sort of glanced across the room and Jim glanced at the same time, and it was just like eyes met. Both smiled at each other and it were kind of, this is quite nice. And it sort of went on from there, didn't it? He were a real gent. Pay for a taxi home, and I said, you can give me a ring if you like. There's my number. I said, will you ring? And he said, yeah, of course I'll ring. He said, I'll ring you in the morning, round about 10 o'clock. He's like, all right. I said, bang on 10 o'clock, the phone rang. I thought, oh, nice. This is what I like.
I thought it was a better idea.
I mean, first thing I thought about was children. I mean, their biggest responsibility, aren't they? They have to be a priority. And I thought, what man wants to take on a woman with two children, especially the age that they are, 13 and 10? I thought, now, does he realise what it's going to be like? And I thought, well, you've got to give it a try. You've got to see, because you can hold back and hold back, can't you? And although, like, my children are priority and I love them to bits, I mean, they're everything to me, I've got a life as well. So I thought, well, just give it a go, and if it don't work out, well, then move on and you start again, don't you? But luckily, like, children are great. I mean, they haven't had it easy, they've had it rough. But they're great. I mean, they've took to Jim and think world of him.
Her and Jim, it's disgusting.
Why?
Because it's embarrassing. She mates will come round and they'll just be like, ooh, all over each other. And it really bugs me.
It just felt right. It just felt right from the start to me. It just felt, I felt comfortable. Be myself. Go to bed every night and cuddle up, and it just feels, you know, the first time we cuddled up sort of thing. Every day, it's unreal.
Scallops.
Scallops. Actually, I saw her in a nightclub, at my friend's nightclub, and we got to know each other. Well, I know I liked her from the first time I saw her. I thought she was very attractive.
And then next minute I was with him. I don't know.
So, you know, we started going away. Going about together.
I think what it was, because I hated him first. And then we actually grew to like him.
Yeah. When I was away, every chance I got, I'd send two flowers. Got to know that there's love there. We used to always be out whining and dining and things, but since we've had the children for 11 years, we haven't really been out.
When you've been married 27 years, it's love, but it's a different kind of love.
Paul Aldridge will tell you that.
What is rock and roll?
We met at a local dance place. I was 14 and Freddie was 18. We've been together ever since.
Ah, that's your best looking lass in town. She was beautiful. And she looked exactly, to me, like Doris Day.
A lot of water's gone under the bridge since then. A lot of water, yeah.
And a few wrinkled.
A lot of wrinkles.
This business today where they say partner. They don't say my husband and my wife, do they?
No.
They'll say my partner now. Mm. In our days, we used to say they were living off at bush.
Oh, yeah.
That was expression.
As Mum and Dad used to say
living off at bush, it meant they weren't married and yet carrying on as if they were.
You were in a relationship a long time. I'm not saying you didn't have sex before marriage because you'd be telling lies. But it wasn't a matter of when you first date.
And that business about sex. When, I mean, you're talking about... You were 14, I were 18.
Yeah.
You got to 21. I bet we hadn't done up before 21. I bet you we hadn't.
I think my memory is a bit sharper than that. But let's put it this way, we were well over 16.
No, I don't know that.
Well, I was well over 60. I was 17 plus, yeah. And I've been going out with him. I'm giving information out. Even my kids don't know here. For me, you've got to be faithful to each other to a certain extent, you know. I mean, me and him have his own freedom. We've always had his own freedom. He does what he wants to do and I do what I want to do. But at the end of the day, we come home to each other. And that's as far as it goes, you know. It ain't all lovey-dovey all time. No. Time still when we're at each other's throats, isn't there?
Yeah, we're all right making up though, aren't
we? What a day this has been. What a rare mood I'm in. Why, it's almost like being in love.
Day 41. Nothing to report.
Day 96. Nothing to report. Day 210. Still nothing to report.
Something to report. Dr. Harris has been replaced. Victory is ours!
Connect with Sony and you connect with a whole new world.
How would you use 200 minutes of free call time?
Spend even longer chatting to people.
I'd probably end up using it for shopping or something.
You know, it's quite a while to... you can do a fair few calls with that.
Getting on for 3 hours. Oh, no more. Three hours, 20 minutes.
Yeah.
It's not bad.
The more free time you've got, the more you can speak to your grandchildren.
They should advertise it.
With 200 minutes free call time every month at local evening and weekend rates, millions of people are better off with BT Together.
Married 5 days after my 20th birthday. It wasn't plain sailing. I mean, with 6 children, we were hard up sometimes. But we got through it. You see, technically redundancy, we could go where we wanted. We could go off any time. The money was there in the bank. And just when we had the money, he developed cancer. I asked the doctor not to tell him. I didn't want him to know. I loved him that much. I didn't want him to be... And yet he knew. I know he knew. If you know what I mean. There was just a feeling inside that I knew, but no, we never, ever spoke about it. I wish now that we had. I really do. So that I could have told him. This always makes me cry. How much I loved him, really. I think about him every day. And I get into bed at night and I think, God, Jim, I wish you were still here. Just for somebody to cuddle. Just to put my arm over like I used to do.
It's that emptiness, it's that emptiness inside. It's like that gut-wrenching, awful feeling and when you wake up in the morning, you, for that second you think that it's gone away and then it's back again. You think, oh, God, no, it is true.
When anybody splits up or they get divorced, that's the only time you know anything's happening. Everybody keeps themselves to themselves.
Time I were in love and got a broken heart. I never sort of felt that gut feeling. It drifted in and drifted in quietly but went out with a big bang. So the heartbreak was much more than the gut, the nice feeling that you get first. It was a girl I met locally and started courting. Ended up living together, buying a house and didn't work out. Heartbroken, end of story really. I hadn't realised that there were more to life than what we were doing, and it just became stale. It was a slow breakdown, really. And neither of us wanting to let go, and her eventually knowing that she had to let go because I never would, and then that was it. It's been a lifetime habit with me. I'm aware of problems. I'm not always aware of the cause of them, and I sort of do the old ostrich trick, put my head in the sand and think, well, it's not me and not my fault. And when it did happen, I was gutted and found it hard to accept. Yeah, I was gutted. I had a nagging feeling in my mind, no matter what relationship I've been in, that I shouldn't be there and things weren't quite right. I weren't quite contented. Even if some people get hurt by separating and that's better than spending 50 years drabness.
I can't understand why to be with somebody just for the sake of it, just because. I want to be with somebody because I love them, because I want to be with them. Otherwise, there's no point in it.
Everybody wants to be loved, I think.
Yeah.
You're all searching for that one person. I mean, like, you all love the
same. It's a different type of
love, isn't it?
And love to me is most important anyway. Because without love, what have you got? You know, there's no sun no more. It's all raining for 52 weeks a year. 365 days, you rain, rain, rain if there's no loving job.
Your granny always says to you that you'll know when it's right one, and you always think, well, how will I? But you do. You just know that it is the right one. That is the person that you want to spend the rest of your life with.
I've got you under my skin. I've got you deep in the heart of me. so deep in my heart that you're really a part of me. I've got you under my skin.
Lynn were a friend who I met about 4 years ago. And I think probably Lynn and I had become attached and romantically attached and probably fell in love at a different time. But for one thing and another, times weren't right. I mean, she had boyfriends and relationships and I did, and I were out of them and she were out of them. And we were ships in night, really. We used to have a pint in pub and have a bit of a laugh. And then just out of blue, time just became right.
It was really, really strange, because I'm a big believer in fate and destiny, and Richard thinks that's a load of rubbish. I ended up coming up here for supper, for tomato soup. Tomato soup and Parmesan cheese on top. Soft white bread. Richard knows how to treat a girl. And then I stayed the night. And it was just like, oh no, you know, it's sort of that, it was weird to cross that barrier.
She's my best mate, and that's massive important to me, because now I'm actually with somebody and doing things with somebody who I love and is my lover. And I adore her, you know what I mean? And I fancy her all the time. And we can talk like mates would, or we can whisper like lovers do. And being in love and making love is, it's not even sex, it's different. It must be a chemical, I don't know. I don't know anything about the human body or how it works, really, except for obvious things. But you can feel it as though it's an adrenaline thing. And it just turns it from sex, which is nice, into love, which is wonderful.
I knew that I was starting to fall in love with him, and I just thought, hang on a minute here. And I know, like, Richard's track record, it's like, let's just be careful about this one. Because I didn't want to spoil his friendship either. I didn't want that to disappear.
And everything that's important in your life that gives you pleasure suddenly pales into insignificance. It becomes a byproduct of what you used to be.
Feels like he's part of me now. He's part of me. He's my partner, but he's like my soulmate.
You just know when you're in love. How do you know?
It makes you
feel so different. I don't know. It's something you can't explain. It's such a strong thing.
Fly me to the moon. Dee 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 dee. La da 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 da. Fly me to the moon.
We could live anywhere as long as we're together, it don't matter. But love lane, yeah. It's ironic, isn't it, really? And we have put the love back in love lane.
I love Rita because of everything what she does. She's everything for me.
It's like an ad suite with a soft centre.
Nobody should take love for granted. But you know it's there, and you feel easier.
Fly me to the moon, and let me play among the stars. Let me see what spring is like on Jupiter and Mars. In other words, hold my hand. In other words, darling, kiss me. With song, and let me sing forevermore. You are all I long for, all I worship and adore. In other words, please be true. In other words, I love you.
I can easily describe what love is. Love is...
Oh, bless him. It is, though, isn't it?
Mm.
That's what it is. It's me and Richard.
Yeah.
To order a Channel 4 directory featuring sources of support for all aspects of relationships, telephone 0906 55 44 044. Calls will cost no more than £1.